Hello friends, welcome to the channel Deep Talks. My name is Naman Jangid and today we are going to discuss about NPT and NSG. So starting with NPT, what is NPT? How this treaty formed? What are its objectives? And how this is relevant to India? These are the four points we are going to discuss. So coming on the very first point, what is NPT? Friends, NPT stands for Non-Nuclear Proliferation Treaty. Here comes the word proliferation. Proliferation means expansion. So if we add this in a definition, we get Non-Nuclear Expansion Treaty. So what this treaty want to say? This treaty want to say that we does not want further expansion of the nuclear weapons, nuclear technology and nuclear material. Coming to the next point, how this treaty formed? What is the history behind the formation of this treaty? So friends, the formation of this treaty related to the US nuclear attack on Japan. US detonated its very first nuclear bomb on Japan, on Hiroshima and Nagasaki in 1945, which led to the very terrible consequences. And watching that the consequences, and it cannot be happen in future, it cannot be repeated in future, this treaty came into the existence. Friends, coming to the point, what is the objective of this treaty? Before coming to the point, what is the objective of this treaty, I must tell you that I skipped one point before in the history of the NPT, that US attacked Japan in 1945. But when this treaty formed? Friend, this treaty formed in 1968. Okay, coming on the objective of this treaty. Friends, objective of this treaty is very simple. It want to limit the export of the nuclear weapons, nuclear technology and nuclear material. According to this treaty, countries having the nuclear power have to abandon their nuclear power and they can use their nuclear technology only for the peaceful reasons. It sounds good that it want peace in the, this treaty want peace in the world. But where is the problem? Why some of the countries are not still signing it? Friend, according to this treaty, the countries who had performed nuclear tests before 1970 are the only countries which will be termed as nuclear powers, which means that they can keep nuclear weapons with them and no other countries can keep nuclear weapons with them. And these are the five countries which are termed as the nuclear power. And which are these countries? These countries are US, UK, France, Russia and China. And remembering that these are the same countries which were the member of the United Nations Security Council. And other than these countries, they can keep the nuclear technology but on some condition, and they can use their technology, nuclear technology, only for the peaceful purposes. This is the reason why India has not signed the NPT. And including India, there are four countries which have never signed the NPT, and these are India, Pakistan and South Sudan and Israel. These are the four countries which have never signed the NPT. Why India is not signing this treaty? Friends, from starting only, India called this treaty discriminative, and India is not in the favor of this treaty because India says that the countries who had performed nuclear tests before 1970 are the only countries which are termed as the nuclear power. Why not India? Because India had also performed nuclear tests. So why cannot be India as the nuclear power? This is the reason why India is not signing the NPT. So, and other reason is the most important reason. So friend, you know very well that we have very friendly neighborhood, China and Pakistan. So, and we know that China is already a nuclear power and Pakistan has not signed this treaty yet. So somewhere there must be a danger for India. So this is the reason that India is not signing NPT. What if India signed NPT? Friends, very first point, if India signed NPT, then India is considered to be non-nuclear weapon state. And the second point is, India have to amend their nuclear technology. And third point, India cannot perform nuclear test. Our next topic is NSC. What is NSC and how it is formed? Friends, NSC stands for Nuclear Supply Group, and the reason behind the formation of NSC was the Indian nuclear test, that is Smiling Buddha, on 18 May 1974. Because all the countries were shocked to see that how could India manage nuclear weapons and technology. That's why NSC came into existence. Friends, main objective of the NSC is to reduce the growth of the nuclear weapons and to regulate the international nuclear trade. So NSC was formed by seven founding countries, that is US, UK, France, Russia, Japan, West Germany and Canada. Friends, there are 48 countries who are the member of the NSC, and out of 48 countries, if any one of the country decline for the approval, then application will be rejected. And I must tell you that India for the first time applied for NSC in 2004, then in 2009, and then in 12 May 2016. So India is still not an NSC member. So what are the reasons? What are the country making excuses of? The very first reason, CTBT. Friends, CTBT stands for Comprehensive Test Ban Treaty. This treaty says that we cannot perform nuclear test anywhere in the world. And like NPT, we have not signed CTBT yet. But friend, there is a problem. There is no such guideline that we have to sign CTBT and NPT to be member of the NSC. So that's why I call that the country are making excuses. There are no such guidelines that we have to sign the CTBT and NPT. And the second reason is China. China is our biggest obstacle on our way of NSC membership. China is continuously supporting Pakistan, and China is saying that if India can become the member of NSC, then why not Pakistan? What if India get membership of NSC? So very first point, friends, we can export import nuclear technology. Second point, we can trade in the international market. Friend, third point, we can invest in the foreign countries. Fourth point, friends, India has the shortage of uranium, and after getting the NSC membership, we can import uranium. And the very last point, friend, that we can manage our nuclear energy.